a miss.
Fashion.
Assemblies.
Is it?
Definitely the people. I mean, people always say you always get like the different social groups, but there just seems to be something about Thurston where everyone likes each other, talks to each other.
Great banter. Love the people here.
The people, I'd say. I miss sort of just being able to wander out onto the field and just see everyone.
I miss all the people around me and lunchtimes, baby.
I'm going to miss people such as these guys. Although they're a bit annoying sometimes, they're actually alright and they're good friends. And I'm glad we've made a bond which I hopefully will carry on for the rest of our lives.
Definitely the banter in the banter.
Yeah, definitely. The shop. Casey's house.
Really?
Yeah. Really? Taking a piss out of
Brian. I just miss such the wide range of people. Everyone gets on so well here. I just miss being with such different people every day and interacting with all different people. I will miss that hugely.
Yeah, I think I agree with that. I think that I'll miss the camaraderie of, you know, having all your friends together in one place. I mean, it's really quite a sad occasion that we're leaving.
I think I miss the computer room, like everyone's always in there chatting.
Yeah.
You see everyone in there, yeah.
I miss the banner and the banter too.
Oh god.
Their relentless insistence on a good sense of humour.
Probably the curve. Make some good raps in the curve.
They also have a fine selection of herbal tea. It's fast. It's chamomile, it's green tea, it's Earl Grey.
Isn't there an elderflower?
There's elderflower, there's chai, there's...
Green? Did you say green?
Yeah,
you did.
There's peace and calm, there's...
Oh, you got breakfast tea as well.
You got breakfast tea. You got all kinds of tea. Yeah. That's what I'm going to miss about the school mostly, actually.
Wide selection of tea.
Yeah. The study periods and just doing nothing in them.
It's going to be weird not to see everyone.
What about you,
Joby? I'm going to miss psychology lessons with Joe.
Oh, that's really nice.
Thanks.
I'm going to miss their sunny personalities and the fact that they don't really know which book to sign out in still after 2 years. Is it the pink one? Is it the green one? What's the time? It's a big clock in front of you.
I'm going to miss people such as Sophie and Harriet. People who are just nice people to be around, just happy, and they just make me smile. And I'm going to miss people like that.
Thoughts of the week.
Miss Ford?
Yeah.
Tom Reeve. I love Tom Reeve.
Yeah, Tom Reeve. I'm also going to miss the way the librarian always walks up to us and goes, right, I know I told you this once before. Please be quiet. I'm not the bad person here.
I'm
going
to miss the excuses that they put in the book. Yeah.
What will you miss most about Thurston?
Find his mum's cooking. As a hard-working student myself, I was, you know, under pressure to get my essays and stuff in, but I handled it really well, I think.
People like Tom Devlin saying people are Helms and stuff like that, I think that's quite unpleasant. I'm not gonna miss having to remind Harry Turner that he's got to actually do some work in school rather than working at Waitrose.
No, I'd agree, I won't miss the work, I hate it.
What won't you miss about Thurston?
Lessons. Whenever we're meant to do an essay in philosophy, just, right, we need to get out of this somehow. Any plans, guys?
I won't miss Ben.
Could we go to college together next year, that's why.
I could say mean things, but I'm not going to.
Me too.
I'm not going to miss the 11, year 11s doing little twat laps and little mopeds outside. Trying to work. Whee!
Coursework. Point.
What won't you miss about Thurston?
Fire alarms.
Some of the teachers.
All the revision, all the homework.
Having to put a reason why you're late and putting late.
Yes.
Not being good enough.
Definitely the work. I will not miss the work one bit.
But then you just make one up, like stuck behind a learner. That's fine.
The constant demands for chocolate brownies, I won't miss that, I don't think. Yep.
Can you come back to it? Making friends.
I am most proud of naming the Kerr. It'll be my legacy to Super Bowl.
I'm having a really fucking good time.
Doing relatively well without ever really being here very much.
I'm quite proud of our Mr. Morrison video last year.
I think it
impressed, well, made a lot of people happy at least, and it was a nice little farewell, so that sort of stuff really.
Mr. Morrison takeaway as well.
Easy for me as head of year 13, it's when everyone starts to get their offers in from universities, every single one, makes us all very proud.
I think what it all revolves around is Helen.
Yes,
Miss,
well, first of all.
Miss Wilson, of course it does.
I mean, Helen, you know, I'm on first name terms, I don't know about you two.
Helen is very inspirational and student of the month, so I won't miss them.
Yeah.
I got student of the month. I'll go shoot them
off,
but
no, she's going to be the best student in the
month. Last day,
yeah. Wait, they've henchest, hench of the month.
Bum bum.
Bum bum.
Bum bum. Bum bum.
National Cup for the school football team. That was the best, yeah. Just going Debs and all the lads.
Actually getting a confirmed from my university options, I was really happy about that.
Right, what's your proudest achievement, mate? It's the big
probably
question.
The teacher's asking me, why exactly are you here?
What? I'm pretty much proud of all the goals I scored on my birthday.
So many. My proudest achievement was definitely being part of the football team without a doubt. Reaching the last eight in the nation was a phenomenal achievement. And also captaining the side in Tom Devlin's absence against John Badescu Academy was very good as well. I enjoyed that, and the amount of people that came down was phenomenal. Thank you very much.
I'm proud of lasting this long in sick form and in Thurston in general and not going Columbine and just killing everyone in the school.
I'd say my proudest moment of sick form collectively is probably making it to the end, considering that I, you know, was pretty rubbish last year.
Still on.
Thank you, Dan.
It's got to be the football. It's got to be the football. Against the Reading team, who were practically professional footballers, and not getting trials, and how many of you turned out to watch them?
Oh, and I remember you lot when you were tiny, well not tiny, everyone was taller than me, but little year nines, and I just missed them all so much. And you're my first tutor group, and to see you actually make it all the way to year 13 is a great achievement for all of you.
Proudest achievement?
What, at TCC?
At TCC, yeah.
I don't know.
Getting that A in my history essay.
I think the Thursdays this year was actually spectacular. I think there were some amazing, amazing films and videos on the Thursdays this year, and yeah, I think they were fabulous.
I'm most proud of the close friends that I've made. Yeah, definitely my close group of mates, that's what I'm most proud of.
And my new haircut, I love my new haircut.
Very nice. I like it, Liz.
I like the fact that I managed to do a whole student party without buying a drink. And I might have got my boots on.
I have nothing to say.
The final part I'm going to miss, the fact that you guys never quite knew what deadlines were, but that's okay.
Miss the New York lot.
Oh.
Tom, that was the best trip ever, wasn't it?
Definitely, yeah.
It was. Brilliant. We had such an awesome time and such banter.
Yeah, basically Miss Peacock brought a coffee up into economics, and as she left the room we replaced it with an empty coffee cup, and she got banged. She was like, where's my coffee gone? That was quite funny.
Mrs. Kelly falling over when she did the sack race.
Will Sharman, just in general, he's just...
But it related closely to someone who supported the football team a lot, although he wasn't actually playing on the field officially. Well, I have to say, apparently, I'm told by a close colleague that he talked children some new language, which we should watch.
I was just going to say, I've learned lots of new words from that student over the last 2 years.
Then, Spriggan!
Speechless.
Miss Molly was asking Miss Hill what her favourite band slash music was, and she goes, "Oh, you too." And I was like, "Oh, Miss, I didn't know you're a fan of our music."
So I asked this class. I asked them, "What's your favourite film?" It should gauge, whether I've got some intellects in front of me or not. I started, unfortunately, with Jeremy Bond and his mate Brad. And the first two I got was Dude, Where's My Car? And Back to the Future. It was not an auspicious start.
Funniest moment, I have to be in New York. Dan Palfrey walking up some stairs, having a quick cheeky look at Miss Cooper's bum and saying, "Oh, I don't think she's got a nice bum." Not realising she's standing right there.
Knockout.
Yeah, I'll tell you one of the funniest moments is where Prince mistakenly grabbed James Bray's testicles instead of a weight at the gym.
Legal?
Oh, yeah, star. Yeah. Putting £3 of petrol in.
That's a great moment. On a sociology trip to the court and stopped off because the PE department hadn't put any petrol in, so decides to put £3. got the sun as well. And the milk.
Again, it's going to be football related. It's probably going to be in relation to Ben Spriggins teaching my son some swear words that he'd never heard before and put me in a really awkward position where I had to explain to him what the F word was, for example.
Oh, there was that time when we were driving to school. And there was a dead cat on the side of the road. And it had obviously been hit a tree, curled around the tree, and it's like brains were just, it was hilarious, it was so good.
When Mr. Morrison was giving Joe a little telling off, and Joe was trying to be nice to him for the rest of the lesson, so I was like saying, "Okay, sir, thank you, sir." And then at the end of the lesson, what did he do? David, "Bye, sir!"
Walk in the club, I've got my swagger on. Man's hating cause I'm the baddest on. Girls coming up to that, who's that?
Nice and new trousers.
Are you enjoying that bagel?
No, she gave me the wrong one.
Is she?
Yeah. Oh, I asked for bacon and cheese and she put chicken in it.
Probably when Molly tried to eat a donut hole.
A squidgy sensation in my fingertips.
Me getting banned from the car park because of the handbrake turn in the ice and the teacher's office.
That's the thing.
On the car park, I think it was me and Ella spinning round in the snow and I fell over. I actually stabbed it. That was funny.
That was a funny moment.
My funniest moment was when the police came to my house and we were all really drunk.
Well, there was this time when Alex de Wilde picked up this. It was an apple core.
Amazing. I think they cut that little run out.
Wow, look at the size of this pear!
But I suggest to the class that we start to build a profile of films that we could share out, have an internal library. Joe Jameson took this a little bit too far, if I'm honest, suggesting at the time, I believe, what? Mr. Lowe, are you suggesting we should have a weekly sleepover and just tell, share films in somebody's house? And I was a bit like, well, that's probably slightly inappropriate, Joe, but if you want to organise that, you go ahead. I doubt I'll be coming. All right, Mr. Lowe, okay, I understand. All right.
Bye!